Even after 10 years, meeting your ex still feels kind of strange. Or maybe it doesn't if you don't still have feelings for her. And maybe it doesn't if the whole world isn't on the brink of war. I don't even know why I agreed to see Kat that day. My thoughts were still lingering on my work. My unit was responsible for the safety of one of the most important visitors Yara had seen in a long time. Joseph Banny, foreign minister of Drovia. Whatever came of his negotiations with our president could make or break the relationship between our planets for generations to come. Yet here I was, fighting with my ex about how often I should call my daughter, pretending that it mattered. As I started walking home, I felt angry at myself. Not for failing to show my daughter how much I cared for her, but for actually not caring as much as she would have deserved. At least that's what I thought I felt like at the time. I was under a lot of pressure due to Banny's visit, and I found it hard to think about anything other than work. I looked at my reflection in the glass and down at the layers of city below my feet. I wondered why I'd opened up to Kat about feeling weird at our old place. I didn't want her to think I still missed her. Maybe I did, because something still hurt when I saw her. Although it might just have been the memory of not getting something we wanted, of having failed. As good as we may be at making sense of things, there are some we can't work into the narrative. I didn't even dare think about the impending political aftermath. If this was indeed murder, it couldn't be. I hope there was a mistake. Maybe Gary had gone crazy. Maybe I was dreaming. Foreign Minister Banny's death could be the tipping point in the conflict between Gyara and Drovia. This whole visit was meant to ease tensions between our planets. Now it could lead to war. The first interplanetary war. Fuck, Neil, snap out of it. You'll figure this out. Focus on the task ahead. Thank you.
Thank you.
It wasn't until I was on my way back to the train that I noticed the park's obscene size. The night was cool, and the mansion district was probably the quietest place in the whole center. It was one of the last spots in the area where buildings hadn't been stacked on top of each other like toy blocks. My head was unusually clear, and to my surprise, I noticed that I was in a good mood. In retrospect, I believe that it stemmed from a sense of purpose driving me forward that night.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I felt sorry for the old lady. Descending through the layers was easy these days if you didn't have one of the few jobs that still existed. Basic income wasn't enough for most people, even around here where living was relatively cheap, although somehow our economy had never been more productive. Thank you.
Thank you.